by early 1983, Karen's parents, Harold and Agnes, and her brother Richard were deeply concerned about her health.
To me, she just did not look well. You know, the eyes are the window of the soul, and I could just see it in her eyes. And she was always tired. So I knew all that time back there hadn't done a thing.
Although exhausted by her eating disorder, on the afternoon of February the 3rd, Karen left her apartment to spend the evening with her parents.
Next morning, the phone rings, and it's my mom, and she's hysterical.
It was the morning of February the 4th, 1983. Agnes Carpenter had found her daughter lying on the bedroom floor.
You know, 9/11 people were there. Took my dad with me and followed the ambulance to the hospital and waited, and then they announced that she had passed away, which personally I think she had at the house anyway.
It just didn't seem to be right, you know. A lovely girl with a beautiful voice, great career. It bothered me in a very serious way.
Love, look at the two of us.
I guess, like everybody else, we said, why, you know, why? But apparently, you know, her progress might have been a little too fast for her heart to take.
So much to say, and as we go from day to day.
I didn't know how serious a disease anorexia was. And basically what it is you're starving your organs.
Let's take a lifetime to say I knew you well.
I don't think anybody wants to get news like that of their best friend.
And love may grow.
By the time we got back to our house, the street was barricaded, media, the whole thing. It's all around the world.
Following a funeral service in Downey, Karen was buried at Forest Lawn Cemetery in Cypress, California.
Very tough. It's always tough, especially watching parents lose a child, because we never, and I'm a parent, feel that we should bury our children. It was very sad, very, very sad.
Every now and then something hits that little nerve that, I don't live in the Carpenter years a lot. That's why it kind of takes you back, and once in a while, it's just very sad.
When the evening comes.
The lyrics have a little more meaning because Karen's gone. When the evening comes, we smile. So much of life ahead. When she sang it, she had maybe 10 years left.
Find a place where there's room to grow. And yes, we've just begun.
There's a saying in this country that you could never be too thin or too rich. And Karen Carpenter, I think, proved that you can indeed.